What's up, guys? This is SciFax here, and this is the Road to Nuclear, where I give you the tips and tricks that I learned when going for the infamous 30 kill streak. And we're finally starting a game with the first round, yay! And as you can see, I have a red dot on my scorpion. This is probably the greatest discovery in the history of mankind. No, not really, but the scorpion's good. It's very good. But I don't know if it was a tough time, but it was an interesting time without the red dot. And I thought to myself, you know what? I'll just throw it on. Why not? This thing is a slaying machine. I could go into every 1v1 with this gun and I'll be happy. Okay, maybe not have to cross the map like right there. I'm talking about just like, we're both 20 feet away, like in the clubs on Plaza, and I need to win a gunfight. Give me a red dot scorpion, and I'll be happy. You know, the MP5 always had a red dot on COD 4. And for me, this gun's always going to have a red dot. It's the first attachment I unlock, so when I prestige it, I might as well prestige it, right? Because it doesn't matter. Fast mags is also on, because, you know, the reload time is nice, but the running out of bullets time is even worse. And at this point, I'm chasing this kid across the map, and since he dies to the level 10 runs around in a circle into a corner and shotguns my boy Cincy. If you didn't know, TCG Cincy is now Nap Cannon because he shoots naps out of a cannon. You guessed it. And at this point, spawns have flipped. These kids are a little bit aggressive. They're going for B, which always helps me out. It's a lot easier to get streaks and stuff when the other players move. And you saw right there that I completely exposed myself to the snipers. That's plays like that that won't necessarily cost you, because I feel like this game definitely rewards you for being aggressive in the right spots. Like right there, ran up to him, just tossed a C4. Get a nice little quad feed right there for the counter UAV and UAV. And there's a Ruthless. And I'm working their spawn. I hate going in the building on this map, so that's why you see me over here. And another tip that I can give you at this point, just go, just do it. Nike slogan for the win. It takes me, you know, that extra 10 seconds to go. It cost me a few kills. I told Cobra right there to please not kill this fool. One away from a VSAT and a couple away from the Relentless, you know. Just go. I mean, of course, right there, I'm not going to run right into him with his nub-ass, I hate the gun, Cap 40, but this guy ends up spawning behind me, and he's chasing. This fool is coming. Almost killed myself with my C4. He ends up running upstairs. Just go. You know, I see the red arrows. I should just do it, baby. Earn it. Like Tom Hanks. Okay, that's not the correct reference at all. He says Ernest, not earn it. But just earn the nuclear medal. Stay aggressive. That's all that matters. Look how sexy this gun looks, man. I love the bloodshot camo. My dumbass prestiged when I was 2 revenge medals away. That was pretty nice right there. When I was 2 revenge medals away from getting a gold, so I think I'm like a level 10 right now. And you unlock this thing, I want to say level 48, maybe, right around the M8. It's the last SMG you unlock. And right here, there's a minute 16 left, and I have a counter AV. I should be all up in that junk. They're backing out. There's only 4 of them. Don't ever stop being aggressive, pretty much. That's all it comes down to. That's the major thing that I learned from doing this. When I finally got it, you'll see on Overflow, I was just all up in there the entire time. I mean, we all were. Overflow is probably the best map for VSAT and for 3-capping. And at this point, I got really lucky. I'm usually always the first idiot shot when we're like have 4 people capping a flag and we're all prone or something. I'm usually always the first asshole to get shot right in the butt. But that didn't happen there, and I woogie boogied out of there. Again, I'm playing like a little vagine. 23-0. 3,200 skull. What is that? 600 skull per minute. I think I might reset my stats once I permanently unlock Counter AV and Blackbird, the next two prestiges. I think I'm gonna reset my stats and try to hold like 1,000 score per minute. That'd be pretty sick. Not gonna lie, that'd be fucking Joe Thrills-esque. So there you go, end of round 1, 23-0. Those fools on the team have backed out hard. And who's the guy? Shooter Nub, dude. This motherfucker right here. He's +2 using a ghost MSMC, I believe. And you'll see what happens. It's some bullshit, baby. It's some bullshit. On smaller maps, where you don't feel like you're not, where you feel like you're not going to take fall damage, or something like that, I definitely suggest swapping out lightweight for hardline or flak jacket, and using extreme conditioning, or using awareness instead of extreme conditioning. Awareness isn't as strong as it's been in the past, you know, say Red Pro, Ninja Pro, but it gives me, it usually prevents the death where somebody's 5 feet behind me and they kill me. A lot of times I'll just run next to somebody or through somebody and I'll get penalized for it and they'll just shoot me right in the back. That death is basically eliminated when I'm running awareness. And it's really good on maps like Turbine, where you can really hear him crunching on the sand and there's not too much action going on. And look at me, man, I'm playing this like a loser. Just, I mean, you'll feel like, oh, I'm gonna go in there and die. You just gotta do it, baby. You gotta go. And kaboom. Don't get the kill. This kid's prone right behind the wall. And I miss all my bullets. What was I shooting at right there? This Warhog freaking goes to town. This van explodes. Van's exploding, man. Whoa. You need to avoid those at all costs. I'm not sure why that one didn't hurt me. But those vans, man, on raid, they will blow up and they will kill your ass like every time. So I get the brutal on my boy shooter nub. I got my V-set. After this V-set runs out, got 3 minutes to get 5 kills. Boom. Got 4 minutes. I just fucked that up. Pick up the claymore kill. Just go over there and kill the sniper. Just go over there and throw a C4. Bam. Quad Warhog. What happens? They spawn C. I'm like, alright, let's go. Let's go. They spawn C. Not gonna throw it at him. Gonna throw it at those two. Don't even get him. Whoa. Whoa. Why did he turn around? Why did he turn around? Why did he turn around? Why? Let's hit you all with a mini Let's Break It Down right here. Classic Call of Duty death. I cannot see him on my screen. Okay, there he is. Look, I'm behind the wall. I'm behind the wall. I'm behind the wall. I cannot see him. If I cannot see you on one side, then you damn sure should not be able to see me. But what do you know? Okay, he's going for C flag. He's just like, I'm just going to turn around and sprint right towards this dude. Look, I'm right out in the open. What is this? I don't know if it's Xbox Live or the Call of Duty engine. I remember Fist made a terrible video about the whole peripherals thing and the angles. They need to fix it somehow. I clearly cannot see him on the other side of the wall, but he can see me perfectly. That needs to be fixed somehow. I don't know what they need to do, but it needs to be done.